Hello, welcome back to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today we are going to discuss what is synchronization in Java and what is synchronized block and synchronized method in Java and how and when we need to use synchronization in Java. We can declare only methods as a synchronized, or we can declare synchronized block. And we cannot declare variable as synchronized. Only two things we can declare as synchronized. What is synchronization? Synchronized is the keyword applicable only for methods and blocks, but not for classes and variables. If a method or block declared as the synchronized, then at a time only one thread is allowed to execute that method or block on the given object. And the main advantage of synchronized keyword is we can resolve data inconsistency problems. But the main disadvantage of synchronized keyword is it increases the waiting time of the thread and affects the performance of the system. And if our method or block is synchronized, then only one thread will be executed at a time. And after completing the execution of one thread, the next thread will be enter. Synchronized block. We can declare only block as synchronized or method as synchronized. Synchronized block, you may lock on an object other than this, which allow to be much more flexible. Here you can see the example. Here I have declared one method, and inside this method I have created one object of student class. And here I am using synchronized block. And synchronized method provide the lock on the object. It will lock the whole object. Hence, if there is no specific requirement, then never recommended to use synchronized keyword. Internally, synchronization concept is implemented by using lock concept. And every object in Java has a unique lock. Every object in Java has unique lock. Whenever we are using synchronized keyword, then only the lock concept will come into the picture. If a thread wants to execute any synchronized method on the given object, first it has to get the lock of that object. And once a thread got the lock of that object, then it's allowed to execute any synchronized method on that object. If the synchronized method execution complete, then automatically thread release the lock. And while a thread executing any synchronized method, the remaining thread are not allowed execute any synchronized method on that object simultaneously. But remaining threads are allowed to execute any non-synchronized method simultaneously. And class level lock. What is class level lock and object level lock? That we have already discussed what is object level lock. Now we will discuss what is class level lock. Every class in Java has a unique lock. If a thread wants to execute a static synchronized method, then it required class level lock. Once a thread got class level lock, then it allowed to execute any static synchronized method of that class, because static method execute at runtime. And while a thread executing any static synchronized method, the remaining thread are not allowed to execute any static synchronized method of that class simultaneously. But remaining threads are allowed to execute normal synchronized methods, normal static methods, and normal instance methods simultaneously. Class level lock and object lock both are different, and there is no relationship between these two. Let us see in the code how this synchronized keyword work. Here it is the example of synchronized method. After that we will see the example for synchronized block. Here I have created one class railway line, and here I am using get line method. And here I have declared another class train, that is extending thread class. And here I have created one more class, synchronized method demo. And this class I am using for to test the code. So let us see in this class. Class railway line, I have declared a simple method. It is not a synchronized method. And inside this method, I am using for loop that will print the value from 0 to 3. It will run 3 times. And inside try block, I am using thread.sleep for 400 milliseconds. And here is another class, that is train. And it extends thread class. And here I am overriding the run method, and train is that constructor, and here I am passing the object for the railway line class. Now I will run this class by creating railway line object, that is a simple class, and here I am using creating the thread class object, and here I am calling train1.start method, train2.start method. And when I am calling start method, it automatically call this run method. Now I am going to run this application, run as Java application. Here it is printing 001122 because it is not synchronized manner. This method is not synchronized, so it's mixing all values. If I will declare this method as synchronized, now you will see the output. It will be in a series. Now I am going to run this application. Here it will print 012012 and not mixing the values. When I will remove, it will print the mix all values 001122. So synchronized method is mainly used to avoid data inconsistency problem. 012012. After completing one execution, second execution is going start. 012. And what is synchronized block? If very few lines of the code required synchronization, then it is never recommended to declare entire method as synchronized. We have to enclose those few lines of the code within synchronized block. And the main advantage of synchronized block over synchronized method is it reduces the waiting time of a thread and improves the performance of the system. Let us see in the code how we can use synchronized block. What is the need of synchronized block? Because if we are declaring a method as a synchronized, then our all code will be in a synchronized method inside, and thread will take more time in execution. If we want to execute only one line, then we can use synchronized block. Here I have created one class employee, and inside employee class I have declared one method employee name. But this method is not a synchronized, and inside this method I have declared synchronized block, and here I am counting the value by using increment operator. And I have created one more class for test the code. Now here I will run this application, run as Java application. And here it will print the name Mohit. And this was the example of synchronized block. It is the synchronized block. And it is the same simple Java code. Okay. These are the important points that we must need to note. When a thread enters into synchronized method or block, it acquires lock, and once it completed task and exits from the synchronized method, it releases the lock. And second is, when thread enter into synchronized instance method or block, It acquires object level lock, and when it enters into synchronized static method or block, it acquires class level lock. Java synchronization will throw null pointer exception if object used in synchronized block is null. For example, if in synchronized instance is null, then it will throw null pointer exception. In Java, wait, notify and notify all methods are the important methods that are used in synchronization area. You cannot apply Java synchronized keyword with the variables. Do not synchronize on the non-final field on synchronized block, because the reference to the non-final field may change anytime, and then different threads might synchronize on different object. That is non-synchronization at all. Okay, thanks.